Hello students, welcome you all. I am Mrs. Divya. We have started with the chapter 1, Reproduction in Organisms, and this is the 5th lecture. So previously we have completed the sexuality in organisms. So in this video I'll be discussing the different stages of life cycle of living organisms. So you can see that each and every organism or sexually reproducing organism has to pass through 3 phases in its lifespan or in its life cycle. Okay, so that is, the first phase is the juvenile phase, or you can also call it to be the vegetative phase, that is generally in plants. The second phase is the reproductive phase, or also called as the maturity phase. The third phase is the senescence phase, or the phase of old age. Okay, so the first one, as I told you, that is the juvenile phase or the vegetative phase. What is this? It is nothing but the pre-reproductive phase, or you can say that the period of growth is called as the juvenile phase. In plants, this juvenile phase itself is called as the vegetative phase. Okay, so you can call it as the period of growth, that is between the birth of an individual up to its reproductive maturity. Okay, so that period, the initial period, that is also you can call it as the pre-reproductive phase, or you can say the period from birth up to the reproductive maturity. Okay, so this stage differs in different organisms. It is not that it is the same or common in all organisms, okay? It varies. Then the second phase is the reproductive phase or the maturity phase. So here the organisms reproduce. So that is, after the juvenile phase, it marks the end of the juvenile phase and it marks the start of the maturity or the reproductive phase of the organisms. So here during this phase, you can see that the formation of the gametes takes place. It might be that is, as you have studied, the sexuality might be in the same individual or in the 2 different individuals, right? That is of the opposite sexes. So gametes are formed, gametic fusion takes place, that is where the reproduction starts. Okay, so here in this phase you can see that the reproductive organs develop. So that is, in the higher plants, for example, if you take, the beginning of the reproductive phase is marked by flowering there. Okay, in animals, the reproductive organs develop, right, and they mature. That is what we call it as the period of puberty. But in plants, as I told you, appearance of flowers start, because you know flowers is the specialized shoot which is meant for reproduction, sexual reproduction. Right, so appearance of flowers marks the reproductive phase in plants, higher plants. Okay, so there are some plants like for example you take periwinkle or the coconut. So these, they flower throughout the year, because the flowering differs in different plants. Okay, and sometimes this reproductive phase cannot be easily marked in all the plants, right? Because as I told you, in some plants you can see that the they flower throughout the year, but there are some plants like mango, jackfruit, papaya, they flower only during certain seasons. That is, they show seasonal flowering, we call it as, right? So that differs from plant to plant. There are also certain examples of bamboo species, they flower only once in their lifetime. That is generally after 50 to 100 years they flower, and during that time they produce a large number of fruits and then they die. Okay, so that is one example they have given. That is, century palm is a common, that is bamboo species, which flower once in 50 to 100 years. So based upon this we can classify the plants into different types. Another example they have given you, that is Strobilanthus kuntiana, that is a scientific name. Commonly this plant is also called as Nila Kuranji. Remember this, many times it is asked in your NEET exams also. Okay, so this Nila Kuranji, the scientific name is Strobilanthus kuntiana. It flowers only once in 12 years. Remember this. Okay. So the last time it had flowered during September to October, that is in 2006. Then in 2018 it had flowered. So next will be after 12 years. So it is named so because of its mass flowering. You can see the whole the hills, hilly areas, that is in Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. It covers the whole of the hilly areas there, and it is attracted by a large number of tourists. Okay, that is why it has got the name Nila Kuranji, because it gives completely bluish coloration to all those that hilly area. So this is about the plants. So based on that, we can classify the plants to be monocarpic, polycarpic. These terms actually they have not mentioned in your NCERT textbook. Monocarpic, in the sense the plants which flower only once in their lifetime, they are monocarpic. Polycarpic, in the sense they give out many flowers, that is they are perennials generally, and they flower repeatedly at intervals every year. Okay. Then in the same way, in animals also, most animals are said to be seasonal breeders, which are reproductively active only during favorable seasons. So depending upon that, we can also classify the animals into two types. Okay, for example, frogs, if you see, the frogs, they do not breed continuously throughout their reproductive phase. They breed only during monsoon season, rainy season. You might have heard during the rainy season, the male frogs croak to attract the females. The birds, you can see, they lay eggs only in certain seasons, not throughout their reproductive phase. But there are the animals, such as human beings, who are continuous breeders, which are active throughout the season. So here, remember children, seasonal breeding and continuous breeding, in the sense, seasonal breeding in the sense, it is not that they breed, as I told you, it is yes, during particular season, but in their reproductive phase. Remember that. And continuous breeders, in the sense, it is not that they breed continuously throughout their lifetime. Okay, they cannot breed in the juvenile phase, they cannot breed in the senescence phase. In the reproductive phase, continuously, they can reproduce. But seasonal breeders, in the reproductive phase, they cannot breed continuously. Okay, there is certain period only when they can reproduce. Okay, so that is the difference between seasonal breeders and continuous breeders. Okay, but generally nowadays for commercial exploitation, what they do is, birds, as I told you, they are seasonal breeders, but which the ones which are cultured in the poultry farming and all, what they do, they are stimulated, they are injected to lay eggs throughout the year by hormonal treatment. Okay, so for many animals, this hormonal treatment is given so that they breed continuously. This is mainly for commercial purpose, which is done by the human beings who are exploiting the animals for the sake. Okay, so this is about the animal breeding. Then when you come to this continuous breeders, generally in the placental mammals, if you take, in the females, you can see there are cyclic changes taking place during the reproductive phase, and based on that we can classify the animals into two types. For example, when you take the non-primates like the cows, the sheep, deer, etc., they show cyclic changes in their reproductive phase. Okay, so these cyclic changes, they are called as the estrus cycle. Okay, so this is called as estrus cycle. So during these cyclical changes taking place, they have a strong urge of sex. Okay, so after that period, you can see that the lining of the womb will be sloughed off, but it is not passed out, but it is reabsorbed in the animals which show estrus cycle. Got it? Okay, so here the cycle consists of a short period of time, right? So during that period only, you can see the term we use here is estrus or heat period, we call it as, right? And the other all periods are said to be the passive or the rest periods. So during this period, the female receives the male for copulation. Okay, so this period is called as the heat period. So the rest of the anestrus period in these organisms, they do not breed, right? Only during that period, the estrus period, they show reproduction. But in primates, when primate females like the monkeys, the apes and the humans, we can see that the reproductive cycle is called as the what? Menstrual cycle. That is, the cyclic changes taking place during the reproductive phase are called as the menstrual cycle, right? So these animals, they breed throughout the year and they are generally called as the continuous breeders. Okay, so here during this period, there is periodic sloughing off of the, that is the rupturing of the inner lining of the womb, that is endometrium, takes place, and it is passed out along with the with blood as what you call it as the menstruation. But this menstruation is absent in the organisms which show estrus cycle. So that is about the reproductive phase. The next phase is the senescence phase, or the phase of aging period. So this phase gradually, it results in the slowing of the physiological functions. So it is nothing but the end of the reproductive phase. So here degeneration starts, both in structure as well as in the functioning of the body. So it is said to be the last phase of the lifespan, which leads to the death of the person. Okay, so in both plants and animals, it is mainly the hormones which are responsible for all these changes, right? You take animals or plants, in both, it is the hormonal changes or the phytohormones in plants, we call it as, which bring about the transition, that is changes. They regulate the changes from one phase to the next phase. Also, there are certain environmental factors which regulate the reproductive processes and the behavior of the organisms. Okay, so this is about the stages of life cycle, children. So as I mentioned, there are the three phases in the life cycle: the juvenile phase, reproductive phase and the senescent phase. So it can be a question of 3 marks, and in between, as I told you, differences between the seasonal breeders and the continuous breeders, differences between the estrus cycle and the menstrual cycle, it is important, right? So in the next module, we'll continue with the events in sexual reproduction. Thank you, everyone.